The path of knowledge is a method to acquire knowledge. To acquire knowledge means removal of ignorance. Ignorance means the blind beliefs, the fantasies, the ideas and concepts that were incorrectly acquired without critical thinking, without checking. And these are now occluding the real knowledge, which is very simple, and I've already given it to you. So the path of knowledge deals with removal of ignorance. What kind of ignorance? You can say all kinds of ignorance, but mostly the focus is on the nature of my own self and the nature of the existence. My relation with the existence. Who am I? What am I? What is this existence? What is this universe? And we ask all these questions and try to find their answers. As a first step, we define all these terms that we are going to use. And to find answers, we need some valid means of knowledge. Then we define the valid means of knowledge and arrive at some answers that are most satisfactory. We define what is true and what is false and arrive at that through the means of knowledge. So this will be the start of the path of knowledge, and this is how we proceed on the path of knowledge. Using the means of knowledge and a suitable criteria for truth, we go on destroying our ignorance. We arrive at answers that are most logical, most rational, and are plainly obvious. We also do the experiments, and we also form models and theories to help us as guides to acquire more knowledge. Obviously, the role of a teacher or a master is central. Your teacher is most important in this discovery. This can be done without a teacher by very talented people, but for ordinary seekers, nothing moves without a teacher. So these are the raw material in the recipe for the path of knowledge. Those who walk on the path of knowledge, I'm going to call them as seekers or knowledge seekers. The goal of the path of knowledge is freedom from ignorance. Knowing that which is most important, which is most essential, discarding that which is unnecessary, which is waste of time, which does not improve our situation regarding the ignorance. This is not a one-day job. This is a way of life. It is a lifestyle, and the seeker is completely dedicated to knowledge. Nothing else. This is not a side job or a hobby. The knowledge will transform your whole life, and your life as a seeker will augment your knowledge. There are no extreme measures in the path of knowledge. The daily life can continue as it does, except if there are major obstacles on the way which stop you from getting the knowledge. Then we intervene and clean them up. We clear the way towards knowledge. And it will be seen that these obstacles are nothing but ignorance only. So the main goal is always removal of ignorance. Removal of obstacles happens whenever it is required. In essence, nothing extreme is done on path of knowledge. There are no practices, as you must have noted. There is no effort required. The effort is there only when the ignorance is too much, only when the obstacles are too big. It looks like an effort. Nothing needs to be believed here. In fact, we are going to destroy all the beliefs. Don't need to eat a specific diet. You don't need to dress in a specific way. You don't need to speak a specific language. There are no rituals. There is no worship. There are no deities. There is only you and your knowledge. There is no dogma. There is no university. There are no degrees. And there are no lofty titles on you. In fact, your name will be lost. Instead of bloating up this individual, it will be shrunk to nothing. The path of knowledge is not going to make you great, powerful. It is going to make you humble, small, free, and blissful. As I mentioned, you are not going to get anything on the path of knowledge. Nothing of material value. Nothing that satisfies the body or the mind or the world. Nothing good is going to come out of the path of knowledge. Nothing worldly will be gained. There are no ethical requirements. Although there is a big list of qualities that are essential to be successful on this path, which we are going to discuss shortly. Those who are trying to improve themselves, trying to make their bodies healthy, or trying to become smarter, better in something, be more successful in their worldly lives, or trying to fix this, fix that, or fix the world, they will be disappointed. It does nothing like this. However, there can be side effects which happen because the knowledge purifies the mind, and the mind is responsible for all our actions, so the actions are purified. This has overall good effect on the daily life also, on the nature of the person also, but that is not our goal. If the person is completely unable to attain any kind of knowledge, only then we climb down a few steps and prescribe purification, which is simply making some changes in your behavior, in your thinking, to remove the obstacles to the knowledge. Some people see it as a goal in itself, and they do not progress beyond that, keep improving the stuff and lose sight of the main aim of the path of knowledge, which is knowledge. It will free you, it will make you blissful, but again, that is not the main goal. Whatever you get on the path of knowledge will simply become an obstacle for you. It is continuous cleanup. It is continuous letting go. The path of knowledge is a negative path, or you can say, in better words, it is a subtractive path, where we do not add, we remove. That which is added is the ignorance. That which is added are the obstacles. On the path of knowledge, we continuously remove these things. We clean the dirt, that is, occluding the light of knowledge. If you find that you have gained a lot on the path of knowledge, then clearly you have failed. If you have all the knowledge, plus the old tendencies, the old beliefs, the old manners, and stupidity, that means you have failed. The old you will be completely gone, will be completely destroyed. It is not a destruction, it is a transformation. It is a metamorphosis. If that does not happen, that means you have failed. Sometimes it may look like that I'm losing everything because it is a subtractive path. It is the same condition as the caterpillar thinking that I'm going to die, I'm losing myself. But the caterpillar does not know that the butterfly is going to emerge, which will be more beautiful, more free. The caterpillar eats everything, accumulates, becomes fat. But the butterfly only drinks the nectar, only that which is most essential and most necessary. If you do not see these changes, that means you have failed. If you believe that I have become something big, now I know so many things, because I am on the path of knowledge, I am superior, nobody can stand in front of me, I am so great, and you have no respect for the great masters, and you see the ignorant people as lowly, inferior, that simply means that you have failed. If you are coming here to satisfy your desires, to satisfy your greed, to get more and more and more, whether it is something material or something intellectual, you will be disappointed. It is a complete waste of time. If you are coming here to survive better, to have a life that is free from trouble, or to bring about a change that will fix this world, make it a heaven, then you will be disappointed. Nothing is going to change except you. Your parents, your society have already done a great job of brainwashing you into getting more and more, to accumulate, to do the nastiest possible things, to achieve your goals, which are desires, fulfillment of desires. This rat race, this disgusting race to become superior, to survive more, to reproduce more, to kill more. And if you wish to do more of that on this path, then you will be disappointed. If you take up this path and keep doing that which you are doing, which you are brainwashed to do, that means you have failed. This path will turn you into a nobody. And very paradoxically, it will turn you into the whole of the existence. If you think that I can go on this path for a few days, I'll get whatever I want, just like I do the shopping in the supermarket, I'll pay my fees and then bye-bye. Then you will be disappointed because this path will never leave you. There is no end to this path. Remember, we are starting at the end. So it goes on and on and on. For the whole lifetime, you will be a seeker. And if you think that I'll know so much that I'll become a master one day, you will be disappointed. In the end, you will know nothing. That is the only knowledge you will be left with, that I do not know anything. So this path is very strange. You have been warned. Now, meditate on this for a while. See whether you want this or not. Decide for yourself. This path is not for the faint of the heart. It is like jumping into an abyss. You don't know where it will take you. The only thing you know that you will be no more. This requires a lot of courage. There are more qualities that will be required, which we are going to discuss in the next part. This may sound very discouraging at first, but I want to make it very, very clear in black and white what this thing is, so that you don't waste your time, so that you don't spend your whole life doing something which you don't want to do just because somebody told you that this is the only path. There are more ways to reach the same essential knowledge that may suit your personality more than this very, very strange thing. As everybody knows, there are half a dozen ways or paths. The path of knowledge is only one of them. Although, this path must be tried first. This is the one that takes you to the ultimate in the shortest possible way, easiest possible way. Believe me or not, the others are more difficult. They involve more effort and they are obviously more strange. This one looks very strange, but is really very plain in my view. So as everybody knows, these are some examples of other paths. The first is the royal path, which means training your mind, cleaning up your mind, getting the necessary powers to realize that which I call the essential knowledge. This path involves a very rich set of training methods. The next is the path of energies, which means using Mother Nature, manipulating Mother Nature to accomplish the same thing, essentially. It also involves a lot of body work and mental work and is very, very strange. There are three or four main branches of the path of energies where we won't go today, but probably will discuss some other day. Then there is the path of actions, which is for very active people, as the name says, who don't want to do the strange things but are attracted to the world. They want to make use of their bodies and their intelligence, their cleverness, their survival abilities. And this has been also turned into a path. If you do it in a specific way, recommended way, it can lead you to the same freedom. You can reach the same heights. Then there is this well-known path of devotion where you simply surrender to something which you think is bigger than you and let your devotion carry you. Just set up the sail and let the wind do the work. You may think that this should be called the royal path, but no, I do not see a single devotee in this world these days. Surrender is the most difficult thing to do. Then there is the so-called lower path, which is the path of occult, where the person encumbered with desires cannot do anything at all and must fulfill his desires first. And that can be done via the path of occult or the path of deities, the path of magic, rituals, sacrifice, and controlling the unseen forces. This path, strangely, can lead to freedom from desires, freedom from the enslavement to desires. Because when all of them are fulfilled instantly, then you don't want anything. And then the seeker gravitates towards essential knowledge. Now, I'm pretty sure there are more, but these are the important ones. And there are branches of these paths, hundreds of branches. So please pick anything you like. But as I said, the path of knowledge will look like plain and boring compared to these. These involve a lot of struggle, a lot of effort, a lot of strangeness, many lifetimes. So good luck. And there is good news also for those who want to try these other flavors to reach the ultimate, but also want to keep the path of knowledge, as this is the human tendency. I want all of it. So the good news is that you can do anything you want while being on the path of knowledge, because path of knowledge involves knowledge and any other path also involves knowledge. You won't be able to twist your body or do the breathing or things like that if you don't have that knowledge. Or you won't be able to summon deities if you don't know how to do it. Knowledge is at the root of everything. knowledge is the most essential thing for any path. Everything else is decoration on knowledge. Some people will understand what I'm saying, but those who cannot will want to take up these fancy ways first, and then will come to the essential path, which is the path of knowledge. That is also possible. That can be done. You can practice more things while being on the path of knowledge. The path of knowledge does not tell you to give up everything. There are no conditions here at all. Your teacher will patiently watch you do the donkey work, and when you are tired, he will give you the essential knowledge. So an intelligent person will not want to waste his time if there is a quick and clean way to achieve the same thing. So this should be tried first. And if you fail in that, you can descend down, try the royal path. If you fail in that, then go down and so on. Remember that everything requires knowledge. Even staying alive in this world requires knowledge. There is no escape from the knowledge. This video series is an attempt to disseminate knowledge. This can be seen as a short course. It is all free of cost, and the content here is copyright free. It is being given away under the Creative Commons license. You can do anything you want with the content except selling it. It is now released in the public domain with no restrictions, and it comes with no guarantees or warranties or insurance. You are responsible for your own decisions and actions. As the ideas presented here can have major consequences, I am going to issue suitable warnings whenever it is required. If you do not understand anything, if you have questions, if you have doubts, you can always ask, and I'll do my best to answer them through videos or by our weekly online meetings. There are so many ways to contact me. There is YouTube comment section, there are emails, there is Twitter and online meetings, and you can also ask for personal calls, and everything here is free and will remain free. There won't be any advertisements also. There is no organization here. There's nobody in control here. There is just you and your knowledge. The path of knowledge is totally personal, private affair. Nobody will tell you what to do. And I think that this is being done for the first time in the history of this planet. And there is no other such content on this planet right now, except the Hindi version of the same series, which is also on YouTube. How is this being done? I'm doing this in my free time and as a service. And of course, this wouldn't be possible without the grace of the great masters who taught me and many others. I'm just returning whatever was given to me freely, unconditionally, without asking anything in return. And so I am grateful to those masters. I am not a guru, I am only a medium, and it is my pleasure to reveal these great teachings to you. And with this, we can start on the path of knowledge. Thank you very much for listening.